Neo. Neurons and symptoms, advances in Leigh syndrome. One in every 5,000 infants is born with a genetic mitochondrial disease. Within this group of diseases, there are some 150 different types of disorders, the majority of which are rare, severe, and cannot be cured. The cause of mitochondrial diseases lies in a deficiency of proteins found within the mitochondria, small organelles in charge of generating the energy necessary for cells to function in different tissues and parts of the body. Alterations to the mitochondria prevent the cells from generating enough energy and thus cannot function correctly. Brain and muscle cells are the ones that use up the most amount of energy and therefore are also the most affected by mitochondrial diseases. But researchers are still studying what types of cells, when malfunctioning, lie behind each specific symptom, identifying the cells responsible for each symptom and their role in the development of the disease is essential before being able to find possible treatments. At the Mitochondrial Neuropathology Laboratory of the Institute for Neurosciences at the Universitat Autònoma de Barcelona, a team of researchers directed by Dr. Albert Quintana has identified two groups of neurons involved in a mitochondrial disorder known as Leigh syndrome, a rare disorder affecting one in every 40,000 newborns that causes the deterioration of brain regions in control of vital functions such as breathing and the movement of muscles. To conduct the research, Dr. Quintana and his team have generated three mouse models for Leigh syndrome, each of them with a different type of affected neuron. By observing the symptoms in the animals, they have been able to identify the role each group of neurons plays in the manifestation of the disease.
So with these experiments, what we have done is to remove one key gene of the machinery generating energy in the cell and in different neuronal cell types. And we have seen that if you take that gene out in excitatory neurons that release glutamate, you see that the animals develop all the motor symptoms that are associated with the disease. On the other hand, if you remove that on inhibitory neurons or GABAergic neurons, that they block the activity in the brain, what you see is the animals start to develop seizures and epilepsy. And for the first time with these results, we are able to correlate what's the neuron that is involved and the phenotype and the symptoms that we see in the disease, and therefore we can design better drugs to actually treat these symptoms in this pathology.
The UAB research team, which has verified its discovery at different levels and with the use of a variety of techniques, considers that these results represent an important step forward in the research into Leigh syndrome. This disease currently has no cure, and in the majority of cases, patients die prematurely. Now, researchers will be able to study specific treatments depending on the types of neurons affected in each patient.